I'm Katherine.
And I'm Alex.
We're the Funks.
And we're here to show you up in Cuyuna Country in northern Minnesota our tiny pine A-frame designed by Den Outdoors.
All right, so right when you enter the tiny pine, you have the cute little kitchen. We have a little retro refrigerator, which we thought just created a cute little extra pizzazz.
24-inch stovetop with the oven and a microwave to go with it. And you can kind of start to get the feel of a very open concept that we've laid out here in the tiny pine.
So this size kitchen also has just enough storage for everything that you need, but not anymore. So in here we have our bowls, cups, plates here that just right above the fridge. And then up here we have just like a little few extra cooking options with spices, salt and pepper, some coffee filters. And then mostly all of the kitchen appliances we have in the little peninsula island that we added to this plan. Where you can see we all just have it fit in here, and then our silverware and cutting boards as well.
There's some stools on the back side of it, so just another spot in the cabin that you can enjoy a cup of coffee in the morning or even sit down and eat. And then we'll get to the dining space next.
So across from the kitchen is the dining space. And so here you'll see we have a small little dining table with a pendant light and two chairs, comfortable to sit two people, but we also provide two stools for if you have up to four people. And you can also see we emphasize a lot of the theme that we are encompassing the tiny pine. We do like to highlight all the different types of trees that grow here in Minnesota, as well as our guest book has the little theme of pine trees. Okay, so the next area we want to highlight is the living room. So it's a very cozy, quaint place. We wanted to make it feel calm and comfortable that you can really enjoy time with just the people that you love and the people you are surrounding yourself with. So we have a pull-out couch here that you can sleep two extra people. We provide books and a record player along with records and board games. What you do not see in this area is a TV because we want people to really enjoy the beautiful outdoor and these wonderful windows on this weekender.
Yeah, and this location is really nice, especially with this layout, because the windows are looking right out at the Pine River. You can't tell now because of the snow, and the river is actually frozen over here in Minnesota. But once it turns spring, the water gets really high and it comes right up to the bank, which is probably 50 feet out from the window there. And there is a lot of migrating birds that come through in the spring and the summer, along with deer we see out here and plenty of beavers, which are really trying to take down all of our trees.
All right, so moving to the back of the A-frame is the little bathroom in here. Alright, so in the bathroom, it has kind of all the basic necessities, your toilet, your vanity, mirror. We do have a standing shower as well. And something we did add to this design was a utility room and an in-unit washer-dryer combo. So in this bathroom, I wanted to add a little bit more of the theme with this wallpaper here that is incorporating our pine tree theme, which goes throughout the entire cabin. So we added this wallpaper here that we just ordered online from Etsy, and we wanted a more dark aesthetic to contrast the white pine that we have everywhere. So we did dark charcoal hexagon tile with black hardware accents as well. And then the washer dryer combo, this was a little splurge that we did add, but we wanted to be able to provide a way to wash and dry, you know, towels or clothes while people are here staying.
The third thing we customized with the Den Outdoors Weekender design is we added a loft space for the main bedroom and sleeping area here in our cabin. We actually did utilize as much space as we could and put a rod here for hanging any clothes, kind of your pseudo closet for the tiny cabin. And let's go check it out. All right, welcome to the loft bedroom space up here. A couple of things to highlight is it fits a queen mattress perfectly for two people to sleep pretty cozy. And it does still promote that view all the way across the cabin through the big windows, and you still get that great view to wake up to in the morning.
A few things we wanted to highlight as well that we added, not as exciting, but we did want to make sure we had recessed lighting for just space. We didn't want too many things hanging down. We just did one pendant light for ambiance in the dining space. Another thing we added was a smart thermostat, so we can track that the heat's working when we're not around, since this is about 2 hours away from where we live. And lastly, some things we splurged on that you don't see in the tour are the in-floor heating and then the spray foam insulation, because we do have harsh winters here. We wanted it to have a nice cozy feeling of warm tile and flooring under your feet, along with very high efficiency for less heat escaping with the spray foam insulation.
So I'd say how we got to this point of owning this land is, a few years ago we were looking for a waterfront property somewhere that we could share with our family and then also rent out as a short-term rental to share with guests. And you actually texted me while I was working till 7 one night and said, do you want to drive 2 hours north and stay in a cheap motel and then go look at some land in the morning? And I said, sure, let's go do that. Yep. So we ended up here and fell in love with it right away.
Yeah, so August of 2021, when the market was pretty hot still, we were looking at lakefront, and we could not find really an ideal lot of land on the lake, so we opted to check out this place on the river. And I think it has more wildlife than we've ever seen on lakefront, which has been what we love the most.
Peaceful, and you have plenty of space, and no lake traffic. Yep. It's just all about the nature and the, I don't know, the atmosphere around the river.
And it's just 10 minutes from the Cuyuna Recreational State Park, where you can go mountain biking, fat tire biking, and in the winter you can do snowshoeing, hawk skiing, you can go cross country skiing nearby. So a lot of outdoor activities, which is right up our alley. So when we purchased the land, it was originally 4.5 acres with the builder that already started the build on the nature cabin that is up and running right now on Airbnb. But we decided that we had more of a vision for this place, and the builder at the time said he also had multiple parcels for sale next door. So we used pretty much all of our funds to purchase the original cabin on the 4.5 acres. So we did a contract for deed for this lot, which is another 4.5 acres, knowing that we would start the construction the following year, which was the spring of 2022.
All a part of your vision from the beginning.
Yeah. So we started our construction loan then and changed from a contract for deed into the construction loan in the spring. And that's kind of how we got started with this build.
And here we are, up and running in January of 2023.
Yeah. Well, I researched a lot. I was looking up multiple different architects, different designs online. There are a lot of options, but what caught my eye about Den Outdoors is just the really easy process and different types of designs and layouts they had. We wanted something that was smaller and an A-frame, because this is technically a guest house on the property. So we wanted to stay under a certain square footage, and we thought this was just the perfect cozy weekender getaway style. The other thing is it's a very affordable design. So we were also in a time crunch with finishing the last cabin, in end of 2021, and we need to start construction by the spring of 2022. So this was already created, designed, and I really liked the aesthetic that it showed, and we really tried to incorporate that style as well as we were designing. So what I would recommend to anyone who wants to build a den outdoor plan is really understand the area that you live in to make sure if you need space for a utility room or, you know, if you have that space for washer and dryer, because those are things that we customized. And we kind of noticed that a little bit after in the process with our builder. So working with Den Outdoors to customize, I think that's a really huge benefit of the company. So I would just definitely recommend understanding what are some things that you want in your space, and then using Den Outdoors to customize those things before you start your process.
Yeah, because I think we actually customized a few things after we had already done our construction loan. Mm-hmm. So that just made the cost a little bit more, because you can't really manipulate your construction loan after getting it. So
a few things we added were out of our own pocket, so highly recommend knowing those little details before you start your construction loan. Yeah, so the future plans for this place is to use it as a vacation rental. This is one of three properties that we have on the 8.5 acres, and our goal is to provide a getaway for friends, families, or even utilizing all three for, you know, family retreats or little micro elopement weddings as well.